conversion. And then another is when Jesus, when you take on the attitude of Jesus, as Paul said, have the attitude of Jesus. Have the attitude of Jesus. Paul said that to all of us. Have the attitude of Jesus. And when you have that, naturally you will flow option for the poor. The way Jesus opted for the poor, loved the poor in a preferential way. And if so, if you are a lady or if you are clergy, Pope Francis has this to say to us. If you have an option for the poor, preferential love for the poor, then you must also have preferential pastoral care for the poor. And the poor in the church, the rich people, as I said, must have evangelical poverty and be on the side of the poor as they struggle for future justice. And the rich should make use of their resources to help the poor rise out of poverty. Social justice in our day, struggling even in law, laws that are entrenched in partiality to the powerful and the rich. Even land reform is like that. The poor in the church. According to PCP2, the active presence of the poor in the church is necessary. And the active presence of the church is in two ways. One, participation in decision making. Number two, realizing the evangelizing power of the poor. If your parish is built around BEC, you have the BECs in the barrios. Barrios. And in the barrios you have the poor farmers, ordinary farmers. Of course you have also some rich people in the barrios. Those who own rice mills are usually the rich ones. The rice mill owners. But most of them will be poor. How do they help you in decision making? There are parish barangay councils, parish councils, or pastoral councils in the GKK. And in the GKK, the representatives must go to the parish council. And in some places, there are PECs, where parishes and dioceses are built up through PECs. The mandated organizations have representatives in the diocesan pastoral council, but most of the members will be coming from the GKK or the PECs. Is that difficult to do? Yes. Difficult because it needs a profound conversion. Conversion in the renewal of structures. Secondly, the evangelizing power of the poor. I am not from a poor family. Middle class public teachers, public school teachers. I never was, I went to school with teachers that were not stitched here. And I went to high school, Christian high school, like my other classmates, bare feet. Bare feet in Marbella. There were no big groups in Marbella, no South Carolina at that time in the 1940s. We went to school in Notre Dame. Then my parents would say, you go to work on summer so that you can pay your hotel in the school. And I would say, Ma, utang natin yan. Now, you are the one who went to school, so you go, okay. So I worked summertime with my brother. And my work was to sift the sand as they build hot blocks. Sift the sand so to separate gravel from sand. And that's how I paid my utang in school. Even if anything from a middle class father, I never been a star. It is only when I became bishop that I learned the culture of the poor and the lifestyle of the poor. I would go up to the mountain city of Pawan. To the mountain city of Pawan, where I got the title of Filipinos. And then we would bring our own rice and gula for 3 days, that would be our meal. Morning, noon, and night, rice and gula. But the first evening after my meeting with the tribal, the University of Fort Glass, I saw the literary teacher, Ongkar was his name, with his family. We ate, we finished the gula, and then I saw the children with the mother eating rice and salt. No more gula. And I told the Paris priest, they have no more food. It was the wrong comment, because I was expecting the priest to tell me, my hour has not yet come. But the Paris priest said, we have gula, sack of gula down there. So they had gula, and for the rest of their meals, for 3 days we were there, all of us had gula. But I was a privileged missionary because I was a bishop. And there was one hut, one room, and that was the kitchen, the sleeping place. And because I was a privileged missionary, the bishop himself, I was placed between the children. Like sardines, my God. And the mother and the father were here, and the parish priest was there. But I was in the middle of the children. But the doctor had told me, do not touch the children, because they have an infectious skin disease. No wonder they were pale complexion, because their skin was peeling. And so I had my arms like this. And then during the night I woke up, and one child had her arm around me, and the other child on the other side had her foot around me. And I said, wow, never mind the infectious disease. So I slept soundly after that. But here is an example of sheer poverty. You can only learn that not only through an encounter with Jesus, the poor, but an encounter with the poor and their lives. You need to be immersed somehow among the poor, so that that evangelical poverty that Jesus speaks in becomes real to you. You need to go out of the comfort zone and be with the poor for a while. Those two things. Active presence of the poor, participation of the poor, realizing that evangelical power.